Hey guys, this is Eskimo Poodle, and we are back with Let's Play Resonance of Fate on the Sony PlayStation 3. Last time, we came back after a bit of a break, and I thought I had the combat system down, and well, it turns out that I did a little bit, but not as much as I would like. But you know what? We shall soldier on, and hopefully not die again. That'd be awesome. If not, well, oh well. Let's see, actually, I don't need that for you. I do actually want to go to you and see if I can't put that on there. Okay, yeah, there we go. That means your cocktails are... Oh, maybe that's what that was that I was looking at earlier. The numbers that I wasn't sure. Yeah, okay, those are your grenades and stuff. I'm not sure how I didn't miss that earlier, but oh well. Leanne, is there anything I could put on you for if I need to switch over? Yeah, probably just the first aid. That'd be decent. Not that I actually want to use that right now, but there we go. Okay, now as for you, when you switch over to... Oh, I guess you don't switch over. For some reason, I was thinking you switched over to the metal-coated rounds or whatever. You know what? We'll save those for when we actually get into a battle with the one guy there. Okay, and I went ahead and took a quick glance at the video that I rage quit on to make sure we continue going in the same direction. That way we don't side path or anything like that. And it looked like I took the blue route here, so we're going to take the blue route. Again, I'm not sure which way we'll end up leading towards the... I'm not sure which way we'll lead towards the boss or anything like that. So I'm just going to go ahead and try my best here. Let's see. Now, I forget, will the machine gun destroy these drum cans? I don't know, actually. But you know what? Let's go ahead and... Okay, that kind of destroyed me, actually. And that's not quite exactly what I was going for there. Okay, let's just go ahead and hero charge you then. I didn't actually look at your weaknesses and resistances. I should have, but well, I didn't. Oh well. Okay, there we go. Got you. Now, something I want to try. Ow. Besides getting body slammed, that's not something I really want to try there. I do want to go this way, and I want to attack that. There we go. That did plenty of damage to you. It did a little bit of damage to my characters as well, but ow. I think we'll live. Okay, you are targeting Zephyr, and Zephyr is nowhere to be found. So that is beautiful. Okay, let's go ahead and... Perfect. Take care of you. And you. I don't know how much damage that'll do to you since you are hidden, but looks like it does plenty. And okay, we want to take care of Big Dwellist here. Which really would be a good name for, in my opinion, this guy. But then again, I guess Pistol Dweller is good enough, I guess. Got you. There we go. And yeah, let's just target your can near you. That way that blows you up. Beautiful. That worked out perfect. Yeah, I didn't actually look at anybody else's weaknesses besides... I'm just going to call him the Iron Crab thing. I don't know why I didn't look at anybody else's weaknesses, but that's what I looked up. By the way, when I came back through the area to do my little bit of leveling... I didn't go any further than when I had played. Okay, so I don't know why they choose to do this, but for the colors in this particular room, they're kind of a pain to see. But the way we came in, that's orange, and the way that we're going forward, that's red. Granted, they look extremely similar, and if you're colorblind or even not very good with colors, then you might... go out the wrong way or something and not be able to figure out where you're going. But other than that, we should be A-okay. Okay, yeah, now all you guys, this is gonna be fun. Stray curves. Yeah, there are too many of you guys here, and that might be a problem. I think this is where I died and rage quit last time. Okay, you guys are all targeting Zephyr for the most part, which is fine. I don't mind if you guys target Zephyr. I want to not to get in the way of that barrel right there, though. Okay, that did a fair amount of damage to you. I can deal with that. Perfect. Now, Zephyr, I'm going to go ahead and switch over to your metal coat of rounds and see if that actually does extra damage to you. I don't know if it does, but if it does, hey, that'd be awesome. It seems like it does a fair amount. Then again, that could just be all the scratch damage, so I'm not really sure. Okay, and that answers my questions about the bullets. It seems that you use one per round of attacking here. Let's see if I can't actually... Okay, Molotov cocktails. We're not going to bother with the dog droppings. And I want to... There we go. Probably could have got closer and did a little better there, but oh well. And actually, I probably should have aimed for the barrel now that I'm thinking about it, but whatever. Let's see, you are targeting... Oh, you're on fire. That's perfect. I like that. Okay, you are a bit close, so you might not... You might get stuck on something, which would be irritating. Okay, you, one of you, are down. That's perfect. I can deal with one of you being down. That's beautiful. I'm going to go ahead and put you back on no rounds, just for the fact that that makes my life a little better. I'm not going to bother attacking you, because you don't have any scratch damage. And the crab leg got in my way, you rat bastard. Okay, put the cocktails back, or the guns back on, that's fine. I want to take care of you, otherwise I will be in critical and that won't be good. Okay, good. They actually do drop more machine gun MSs. That's nice. Okay, Zephyr, you are critical. So I'm going to go ahead and see where... Go away, leave me alone. There we go. Okay, apparently because he got attacked and he lost the bezel, I wasted my turn there, but okay, whatever. Yeah, some of the nuances are lost on me sometimes, but we shall get through this. Let's see. Yeah, I might just end up having to die here, unfortunately. Yeah, that's not gonna work. I'm just not sure how to deal with these massive groups of enemies, and I don't have a proper means of dealing with, it seems like. Let's see. Now, are there any more barrels I can take advantage? There's a gold box, but that's not going to actually help me, is it? No. You are targeting me. That's irritating, but... Okay, you're on fire, so that helps a little bit. Who's targeting who? Okay. Yeah, the problem with the first aid kit is it's not going to actually help out a lot since it's not targeting the actual damage. It's targeting scratch damage. Yeah, I'm probably going to die here, but oh well. Damn cover! Dog, you pile of junk. Okay, there goes my game over right there. Okay, we're going to try this again here. We still have some unfinished business. And this time I might just go straight for the... Okay, anybody want to come over here? That'd be great, thanks. You. How about this? There you go, there's a little bit of scratch damage for you there, pup. Let's see, I want to... You know what, screw it. There, the dog's out of the way. I don't gotta worry about the little guy. That's perfect. I can deal with that. Let's see. who else has a barrel nearby? That barrel might not actually be close enough to do anything. It might actually hurt us more than anything. But you know what? I'm going to go ahead and give it a shot here. Yeah, it didn't really help out too much, I don't think. But let's see who else we got here. Bunker, Kurrigan. Yeah, the problem is there's three of these damn machine gun dudes, and well, they're a bit irritating to deal with. Okay, let's see. Okay, that should do a fair chunk of damage to there. Not quite enough to kill, but well, decent chunk at least. We're not going to kill you either way, are we? Zephyr, you're actually getting attacked, so I'm going to go ahead and waste your turn there. By the way, wasting a turn, I think, takes away a resonance point, but considering my ability to use tri-attacks is, well, never all that good, I'm not really too concerned. Okay, I want you to come over this way. There you go. And you're going to go ahead and take off what little scratch damage we have achieved. Alright, so we're whittling you down. That's perfect. I can deal with that. You need some... Let's see. Zephyr needs a little bit of... Apparently I'm not close enough to Zephyr to actually heal him. Okay. Let's go ahead and... Let's see. Who am I targeting? Well, let's start with you since you're closest. And move to you, and hopefully do... Okay, enough to kill you. Perfect. Okay, so that means one of you is dead at least. I can deal with that. That's nice. And goodbye. Yep. That's the problem. I don't want to waste the bezel here, but I also want to just attack you. There we go. Okay, that got the bezel back there. You are not going to... I was about to say, what's going on with that guy? Is he just, like, trying to explode, or... I wasn't sure what he was trying to do, actually. Let's see. Actually, you know what? Yeah, you're moving away from the drum. And you guys are all going for Leanne, aren't you? You know what? Before I get too far, I want to target... Not that. I was trying to target the bezel shards here. That would be decent. Actually, I can target the bezels while I go target... This guy. Yeah, these guys are weak to lightning. We don't have any way of dealing lightning damage. Maybe we'll get a lightning bullet later on in the game, but for the moment, it's not really helpful to know, hey, they're weak to lightning when we can't do a whole lot about it. You want to attack Zephyr. Of course you want to attack Zephyr. You always want to attack the guy that's nearby, don't you? You know what? Screw it. You go for a... grenade here, and that should do some damage at least. There you go. You go for, let's go for this. Come on, we can do it. All right, perfect. We got you. That means you are about to be dead. Let's see. Zephyr, of course, you're being attacked, aren't you? Yes, you are. You know what? I want... Calm down there, dude. Dang it. I thought you had your, Alright, do not attack. Do not attack me right now. Okay, that's fine. Maybe this is, like, the side path route, and I'm not actually supposed to be here. I don't know. So I'm not sure how we're supposed to take care of these guys. Okay, you know what? You go run away. Stop it. Go away, dog. Let's see. Vacheron, you're not being attacked, so that's fine. Let's get you back on the gun, though. Yeah, you're not doing any damage, are you? No. Okay, there we go. That's some splash or some scratch damage. That's perfect. I can deal with that. Damn it. They don't start out close enough to the barrels in order to actually use the barrels to your advantage. And then they don't move. The only person that moves at the start is the dog.
Hey, save it, why don't you?
I'm not sure how to get past these guys. I mean, obviously you can. Just I'm not entirely sure how. Okay, you know what? Screw it. I'm just gonna go ahead and get over here. There we go. I'm just gonna go ahead and Superman through here, and hopefully it works. Maybe I should have two machine guns, but I think I only have one machine gun now that I'm thinking about it. Let's see. You know, I'm just gonna attack you, and well. I don't think that actually helped out too much. Let's see. I was gonna say I was gonna attack the dog, but the other machine gun dude is too far in the way. And I didn't notice that guy was attacking Vacheron, otherwise I wouldn't attack that barrel. Oh well. Okay, I want to go over here. Damn it. I hate when that interrupts your hero run. I really do. Okay, screw you, dog. Too slow. And what the heck? Kill the dog. Did that little bastard take my bezels? He took my bezels, didn't he? If I can't get this, then I might just go back through where I was and try to get out through a different path. Maybe we're not supposed to be on this path right now. I don't know. You know what? You guys are all right next to each other. It's not going to do a whole lot of damage, but I'm going to go ahead and just Molotov cocktail you guys for a little beer. Okay, let's see here. Let's make sure I'm actually targeted on the right person here for once. Because that was screwing me up the last time. I was trying to target this guy, but I targeted the guy in far distance. Alright, there we go. You are ready. That didn't do any damage to you, unfortunately. Okay, you. That should have taken out your scratch damage. I don't know why it didn't. You know what? Screw it. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm going to go ahead and Molotov cocktail you, since that should take care of all your scratch damage there. I hope. Or maybe not. Not sure what's going on here, but and again, this is where I died last time, so I'm not really too surprised I'm having trouble here again. Okay. Why are you guys still alive? Okay, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and hero run you guys. And this should be able to get both of you completely dead. There we go. I think what happened with the first spider dude is that it hit the shield and not the actual main body. And so that caused it to not be very effective with the whole. Screw you guy, go away. Go bother somebody else. And that's why the scratch damage didn't die off. Okay, start with doggy here. goodbye. And then... there we go. That should not completely scratch damage you, but okay, close enough. And then, let's go ahead and... goodbye, dog. Thank you. I'll be honest, I'm pretty sure this particular part is mildly luck-based. Okay, you know what? I'm just going to ignore your turn right now since you're not doing anything useful. Maybe the grenades get better as we go, but for now, they're not too terribly useful. I mean, they seem like they should be nice, but they're kind of eh, really. Okay, I want to go ahead and... not do anything useful to you. You are targeting nobody. You know, that's fine. I can deal with you targeting nobody. Okay, you are still resisting. Where did the rest of my bezels get shattered to? I don't know. Okay, you got all your health back. That is not really fair, like, at all. Yeah, I'm not sure how you got all your health back there, but that's not fair. Don't you... you bastard. I thought I had a full bezel and a half left over. I thought I had more than enough. Okay, one of your shields is dead. Or, actually, all your shields are dead. Okay, good. That makes my life much easier. That means I can just go for straight damage to your... or straight scratch damage to your main body. Perfect, and you are dead. Time to die. I need to get more bezels for more hero runs. I mean, you're supposed to be able to find... oh, more scrap machine gun MSs. Okay, good. You're supposed to be able to find shards out on, like, the map for placing down the hexes or whatever. But I think we found, like, one, and that was from a boss. So it'd be nice if we got more at some point. Ooh, an escape hex. Okay. I'm not going to use that just yet. See, this might actually be a boss here. I'm not entirely sure. And I don't want to look it up. Just I do want to keep the element of surprise going a little bit here. See, is there anything else we could do here? I don't think there's any other treasures. I'll tell you what. If this is a boss in the next room, which it very well might be since it's kind of a dead end, I will try to defeat it. And if I can't, then I will... I think we can actually just back out of the area and go from there. And we can go ahead and try the rest of the rest of the room. Okay, that's a boss or something. Because I won the, the Tar Man boss fight pretty much by pure luck. Okay, let's see, we got the bunkers, and Tesla Tortoise, level 28. Okay, I'm not gonna worry about it too much. Okay, I'm trying to target other parts of the body, because you guys were saying on the Tar Man you could have targeted other parts of his body, but, well, on this guy, it doesn't seem to be much of an option here. Ow! Guy! I don't think that's particularly fair. No, I'm gonna go ahead and try my metal-coated rounds here, and we'll probably still not do a whole lot of damage to the guy. Actually, I'm definitely not gonna do a whole lot simply for the fact that, we're not doing any scratch damage. Oh, and I think actually we are doing damage to a shield now that I think about it. Because I do remember somebody saying that, the the bottom, like, little half circle, that's usually the shield hell. So yeah, we're definitely doing damage to a part of its shield here. Just, well, maybe not great. Okay, you need to... not attack so slow, that'd be great. Okay, what is that sparkly thing that is attacking me here? I'm not entirely sure. I don't feel like I'm too terribly far away from this guy, but apparently I am. Okay, stop killing Ian, please. You know what? There we go. We're nice and close. We should be able to get a couple cocktails on you. Let's see. We should be able to dash past here. And then hopefully do a fair amount of... there we go. That must be what we have to attack right there. And the fact that the hero run got interrupted was not my finest moment there. Okay, you know what? I want to go ahead and keep going here. Ah, you turned around just in time for me to miss my opportunity. You turned. That was cheap. Come on, go for it. Okay, I can see how we're supposed to actually fight this guy, assuming we can, you know, not die. We just got to attack that middle part there. But he likes to turn around and make my life irritated. This guy has a ton of HP. Okay, we broke his gauge, that helps. I don't think it actually does anything for us, particularly. But... okay, your gauge is broken again. So we're doing a little bit of damage here. Okay, is there anything I could use here? That just cures scratch damage. I need... that's actually decent right there. Let's see. Doubles movement speed, that's nice. Clairvoyance, that's not going to help us out. I'm going to use this on Leanne here just for the fact that she can actually use a little bit of health here. Okay, I think I kind of got this boss down. I will try one more time here, and if it doesn't work, well, we'll go kill the stuff on the other side of the room probably next episode or something, but... I can see the general path, what we got to do here. You know what? Ow, that didn't work. I was trying to not waste too many hero points or whatever, but oh well. This guy is surprisingly far away from your attacks for some reason. Like, I feel like I should be plenty close enough to do a regular attack and still get, you know, like 1 or 2 points of damage off, but maybe not. Actually, you know what? Let's do a hero attack with your grenades there, just to see if that actually helps out any. Probably not, but I do want to try. Okay, that didn't work out too well. Let's see, you are back on your... okay, stay there. And then... okay, good. We're doing plenty of damage to its shield right now. That's nice. I like that. Let's see. You go ahead and damage its shield real fast. Because he seems to be fixated on Leanne for some reason. So you go ahead and just Molotov him right there. Yeah, we're going to use up a fair amount of Molotovs here, but I think we'll live. And you want to attack her again, that's fine, I can deal with that. She's going to do plenty of damage here. Okay, there we go. And let's just keep up with the regular damages here. There we go. His side is exposed. Beautiful. You know what? I'm just going to go ahead and let you keep on attacking the shell here just for getting rid of it. That way we can actually attack more of it. Hey, we got all our parts back somehow. Not really sure what happened, but okay. Why did that pull up so slow right there? That was weird. Why are you... This guy has a weird hit radius, or hitbox, or something. Okay. Let's go, targeting thingy. Come on. Like, usually hero attacks will go a lot faster than that. Why are we recovering our bezels so much? That's kind of weird. I'm not entirely sure, but you know what? I like it. I'm not going to complain about it. It's useful. I feel like I actually have a bit more of a grasp of what's going on than I did in the Tar Man situation, that's for sure. Ow. Okay, at least you're attacking someone besides Nan, that's fine. Well, I spoke too soon, apparently. Can't say this will be a happy ending. Okay, let's see here. And I want you to go ahead and continue on your scratchy damagesness. See, we are right next to it. Why are we doing weird... slow charging right there. I don't get it. Okay, right here we're a little farther away, and then it just sped up randomly. I'm not really getting it here, but okay. Let's see. We're just gonna go ahead and keep on attacking the shell here. I mean, obviously we're doing something kind of right here, since we are destroying its shell. So that way we can damage it more. But at the same time, can we destroy the rest of its shell, or are we only able to destroy part of it? I'm confused. Like, if we could target more specific parts... Okay, there we go. We got more of its shell off, that's fine. If we could target more of its parts specifically, that'd be great. So we could target, like, the part that lasers me to death. Thanks. We could target, like, the, what is it, the hoses or whatever, and that might... that might let Leanne heal herself. Okay, good. Leanne, you need to heal yourself. Oh, never mind, you're healed. Okay. I don't get a lot of things about this game, but, oh well. As long as we keep trying. Yeah, we're definitely doing better, like, than against the Tar Man, which was, just kind of hectic, actually. Okay, you're targeting Bashir, that's fine. And you turned around so I couldn't target you. Maybe he does that on purpose. Maybe he says, oh, I noticed that, somebody wants to target my, core, if I'm gonna turn around. See, I am directly in front of this core. Why am I charging so slow? That's kind of weird. Let's see. Let's go ahead and go this way. Come on. There we go. By the way, in case I didn't tell you guys, I figured out that the way you gain your experience points is based on how much damage you're doing, pretty much, relative to the enemy's level. So, fighting a low-level enemy and doing a lot of damage, not going to get you a lot of points there, or experience. Fighting a higher-level enemy and doing lots of damage, that's going to get you more points. And also, it's per character. So, like, let's say Vacheron gets all the experience here for doing a lot of damage. He'll get the experience, whereas Zephyr, not so much. Ooh, scrap microchip. Cool. I'm glad we got this guy. That worked out nice.
You do know what you're doing, right?
I have a general idea.
I'll be waiting outside.
Maybe you should join him.
It may be dark down here, but chandeliers as bright as ever.
It's beautiful, isn't it? It's hard to tell until you look at it from a distance.
Yeah, well, with a name like that, you'd think it would at least give us a little more light.
I like it better this way.
Hey! All done! Saddle up! Time to go!
Hurry up, Zephyr! We're gonna leave you here!
I'm used to being alone.
Sorry, did you see something?
Alright, we completed the Blackout mission and got 25 stars. And as soon as I remember what those do, we'll figure it out. Alright, cool. That boss actually worked out pretty good, and we got another half a bezel. Two more bosses, and we get another bezel for another hero charge. That'd be awesome. Let's see. Where are we, anyways? Oh, we're actually not in the boss room. Huh. You know, I'm going to go back to the boss room and see if anything's there. And next episode, we're going to go ahead and probably just clear out the other side of the power station just to see if anything useful is there. There might be, like... I went the wrong way, didn't I? There might be, like, a mini boss or something. I don't know. Probably not. You know what? This is a bit more irritating than I would like. So I'm just going to go ahead and just run straight through. On the way back, I'll probably fight these guys for experience. But for now, I just want to get to the boss area here. Just to see if anything is... findable. Surprised it didn't actually keep us there. No, nothing over here. Actually, it doesn't look like there's actually anything here. It'd be nice if there was like maybe like a hidden bezel shard or something. That'd be a nice little bonus. Oh, that's saying we have cover, which doesn't actually do a whole lot sometimes. Nope, there's nothing special in here, like at all, at least not that I'm seeing. Okay, alright, so we managed to actually defeat the boss of the area, which is awesome. We got the main story mission taken care of, and next episode we're going to go ahead and finish exploring the Hughes Power Plant, and probably not get out in time to go do anything else, but we'll try to finish it up. So guys, thank you for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good night.